Bear cookie emote. Ah, rip. I like how I'm typing it as I'm doing this. This is great. I'm trying to get my Eurotruck is updating. Come on, Eurotruck, update faster. I still got like a few more minutes, a minute to go. Can I add a screen? I think I still have a wet. I think this might be the one. There it is. Why are you like all the way up there now? There we go. Is that white thing your mic? Yes, this is my mic right here.
Hello.
That's why I'm able to do that. Still waiting that for waiting that thing to update. Because apparently I forgot to update. So I'm going to just stream me updating this game. Because that's what I do best. Not really, that's not what I do best. Can we do a really quick call? For what, Izzy? What do you want to do? Because I'm planning to just stream by myself, and I usually just talk by myself. Oh. Is that a DMO? I spy. Shh, you see nothing. I removed my mic. I want to see how bad my cam mic is. Can we do it after? Maybe? Ideally after? I'll check on that a little bit later. Why is nothing updating? Oh my god, Streamlabs, work for once. Fuck. Hold on, let me check Streamlabs. Oh, wait, you guys can see this. This is interesting. Okay. No, you don't want to see my Streamlabs. I don't know why it did that noise. Where is it? Where the fuck is it? Ah! Event list viewer count. Launch, please work. Are you working? Now you're working. Quatus Easy wants to be part of the stream. Looks for a thumbs up button. Hey, if you bring that back here. Oh, no. No. Actually, I'm tempted to do that one day. Just not now. Why are you still updating? As I'm still waiting for the thing I do, the thing I do. This is a great time. I should have done this a lot long before. Why did you go to 9 minutes and 42 seconds? What the heck, internet? I love you, but no. And then everything lags out. Yeah, that sounds about right. Looks about right. Like, what happened? Oh, okay, now it's coming back. There it is! Jesus Christ. Alright, let's play the game. Alright, this game is gonna load up very loudly. Alright, can the game load up? There it is. Game up. Oh, hey, we are in 1.3.1. Looks like I'm playing American Truck Simulator next week. Woohoo! If you're using mods, blah, 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 blah. Okay. Is it all removed or do I have to remove it? I might have to remove it. Damn! I'm gonna try. If it crashes my game, it crashes my game. So I realized that I have mostly my friends in this chat this time, and this is also going up as a VOD straight up because F it. I always do that. Welcome to Truck and Talk Thursdays, where I usually talk about shit. We all talk about shit. I drive trucks with a controller because that's all I could afford. I could drive it with a controller, but I can't drive it with a wheel. Unless if someone wants to give me a wheel and sticks. Wheel and sticks. Wheel and stick shift. Why is your avatar for Spam 2 look like John Tron? Well, you see. Game change detected to avoid blah 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 blah. Oh, okay. Thanks. Okay. What is this new event? The 2018 of the European Truck Racing Championship. I can't believe that's a thing. And all the teams that needed transfer tubs. Only deliveries over 200 kilometers are available. Using external contracts, deliver races to at least 12 different cities. Oh, okay. Well, lucky you, you got Cluster Truck.
That's cool. I actually might actually do a contract here. So yeah, welcome to Truck and Talk Thursday. So we're supposed to talk shit. Especially, well, this is weird because you guys are my friends and I usually don't talk about it. But I guess I could talk about it. But first, I gotta figure out a delivery. I gotta figure out where I wanna go. This is the map of the Europes. Get angry when jumping trucks. I wish I had Cluster Truck. That's a fun game, actually. Careful now. I do have Nightbot for a reason. So stop butting the Nightbot. Wait, let's see. I want to see the map. I've been places that I haven't been before. Or I have been places that I have been before. Okay. Can you make an ass delivery? What do you mean by that? I don't know how to ass a delivery. I drive like shit, if that's what you're talking about. Sure, let's... Actually, that looks cool. Let me drive that. I have to keep it 90 kilometers an hour, but we're gonna try and do this. So hopefully this doesn't break. It's excessive when... Exactly. It always delivers. Just deliver a truckload of ass. I wish that's a thing. Oh, shit. No. Okay. Come on, camera. It's apparently raining in Europe. When is it never raining in Europe? I turned off my engine. Okay. Let's do this again. Let's see if I can... Okay. That's my brake. Let's go! I need lights. I need windshields. Okay. I need lights again. Alright, let's go. So yeah, what I do with Truck and Talk Thursday is basically first I talk about the week. Thank you, Dragon, for the host! One day I should do that. That'll be fun, actually. But I don't know if I could actually vlog a Truck and Talk Thursday doing that, per se. Be cool, but eh. Okay, I'm making this turn. Let's go. We're going places! I'm going to crash. I want to see him get angry. Well, one day. You here looking for a Hawaka? Hi, Dragon. Welcome. I know you just got home, so go get in your comfy clothes and whatnot. I'm gonna break now. Okay. Let me send out a message. Or like that. Or, yeah. Okay, my head's itchy, damn it. Oh, fuck. You know me well. Duh, I do. As I'm green light already. Okay, let's go. Fuck. No. Get back here. Also, I should probably figure out what I was going to talk about this week for Truck and Talk. What was I supposed to talk about? Oh yeah, I was supposed to talk about my week. Because that's what I usually do as I try to... God damn it. I can never catch a break using my phone. Granted, I'm not supposed to use my phone while driving. Okay, so what happened this week that is actually very notable? Except going out with family, like, all this weekend. That was actually fun. Went to places. Maybe went to a casino, because that's what my family does anyways. So, did that, all that stuff. It's so weird seeing your other name, but I still want to call you by your actual name on Twitter. So, I don't know which one should I call you. Should I call you that name or the other name? You know what I'm talking about. And, person, I know you... You know who I'm talking. You know who I'm talking about. There we go. That's the words I'm looking for. Great turn. I hate those turns sometimes. I shouldn't be streaming too high of quality. If it is, that's actually a bit surprising. I actually want to load up my chat on this one, even though I'm looking. Just call me by my real name and I don't care. I call you by tissue or I call you by Brianna. It's one or the other. It's okay. Alright then. I'll keep that in mind as I'm driving through the thing. I just crashed. That was great. Okay. Alright. I just want to pop in my stream and then everything will be fine. Can I leave? Oh shit. How do I do this the easy way? There we go. So I actually do want to see this in a thing. The one time I don't want the stream to be at 1080p, it doesn't let me change it. That's weird, because I have it set for 720p. So I don't know why it actually loads up. I'm rolling. I am so rolling. That's the weird part. My real name is part of your name. I know, Izzy.
Lol.
Actually, you know what? I'm curious. Yes, I know. New event. This is not borderless window. Whoops. Oh, I hope I don't screw up. Okay, good. I'm curious. I should be streaming at 720p, technically. So I don't know what happened. Yeah, I should be streaming at 720p. What quality does this give me? Yeah, so my phone actually says source. That's my stream right now. Come on, focus. Focus on my hand. So mine says 720p source, as it like tries to blurly say it. You could try and refresh it to see if it actually goes down. If you tried, if it actually worked out or not, try and refresh that and see how well it works. You know, my source, like, I put the source as 720p, but sometimes it shows up as 1080p, and I don't know why. All right, let's get going. Now that I've managed to fix that and I can actually see my own stream at the bottom, now it went down. Oh, I dropped frames. Whoops. I'm gonna wait for it to just go down in like the next few seconds. If it went down, just give it a refresh. I should not say that. I don't have chat. Whoever has it running, ask them to refresh and see if it works out. Oh god, here we go. I'm crashing so hard. Okay, it changed to 720p. Cool. All right, cool. Ooh. Well, great to know that my friends could see me how bad I actually drive on Euro Truck Simulator 2, and well, any other trucking game, really, if I think about it. What have I done this week? Because that's what I usually do, Truck and Talk Thursdays. I should probably redo my intro again. Hey guys, Spam Waits here. Welcome to Truck and Talk Thursdays, where I drive trucks and we just talk about random shit. And what I really mean about random shit, I really meant about random shit. I talk about my week. I talk about practically anything, any topics. Apparently the home phone is going off right now. And that's what we basically do. I do welcome my actual friends here on chat, because I actually posted out because I actually wanted to hit the 3 affiliate views. I actually stopped my whole truck in dead center. However, I do have a daily follower goal. I'm pointing it the wrong way. This is Euro Truck Simulator. Oh, did I not change the game correctly? Can you change the game if it's wrong? I might have it. I have it in Overwatch. Whoops. I thought I changed the game title. yeah, this is Euro Truck. I thought I changed it. I realized I didn't. Whoopsies. That's a bit awkward. Thank you. 2. Dragon, put your truck simulator 2. I'm sorry. I forgot. Yeah, there's a 1 and a 2. See, I remember changing my title because I was streaming last night with Dragon on Overwatch. And I had it. I changed everything before then except that. That's true, though. Yeah, no, I know. There's 2 games of Euro Truck Simulator. This is technically Euro Truck Simulator 2. I could have my game on that one. There we go. A little bit better. Thank you, Dragon. We pretty much talk about anything. We go for about an hour and a half to 2 hours. Usually I start around this time. I kind of started a little bit late because apparently I had an update for Euro Truck Simulator. And I was like, oh. Apparently the major update came out, so this might be the last week we're going to be doing ETS2, and we're going to be hopping over to American Truck Simulator maybe next week. I'm going to have to look at the update first to see if it's worthy enough to actually play. I've heard a lot of big things came out on ATS, and I want to be sure. You have 2 euros to your name. That's 2 million euros. Tissue. That's weird to say, but that's your name. I was about to say I want to call you Browner, but that's rather be on a call or whatnot. It's a lot more money than you think, Dragon. So yeah, that's what we pretty much do here on ETS2, Truck and Talk Thursdays. Oh my god, I know my own stream. So I need to turn on the fan. Let me pick up this load. I am apparently going, I think, to Hungary. That's what I picked up in the whole thing. I am worth 3 CAD. Damn it, say my name. Okay, Brianna, fine. Where's my pickup? My pickup is not that. Oh, it's inside, isn't it? Ah, damn it, I went the wrong way. Backing up. Okay, so what happened this week? Aside from I went out with parents, had a fun time. May have went to the casino because that's what me and my parents usually do. It's on the other side. Oh, I lied. Did that. And then the big thing that happened that I have talked about this during the last Truck and Talk Thursdays. I need to turn on my fan. It's so hot. There we go. Much better. Ooh, itchy head. Okay. So yeah, what happened, what I was talking about last Chuck and Talk Thursday was, oh god, the wheel, come on, wheel. Was I went to San Francisco to pick up the cap and gown, which was a very, very daunting task. It's gonna be on the vlog tomorrow, but I'm gonna just explain it anyway, so if you guys want to see what I did, which I tried to vlog it, because it was such a long line, there was too much people, and I still got a big fat social awkwardness whenever I try to record or take a whenever I try to record. Picture's fine. But when I record, I go like, how do I do? I feel weird vlogging in like with a lot of people that I don't know. Yeah. That was quite an adventure as I'm backing this up. So I guess that day started off really early in the morning, hoping that I can make it there in time. Which I did. I mean, I was gonna be there by 11. They started doing the distribution, the rentals and distribution. Rentals and distribution around 8, I think. That's what I've heard, and I think that's what I remembered. So I went on the train because that's how I usually go on the thing. That's how I usually get to San Francisco. I got on train. Pretty packed train, apparently, considering the Mother's Day weekend. That was right before that. So I guess everyone was going home, and some, I think, are going to work. Not really work. That's a really late train. I should go to work. So I went on. Yeah, it was a packed train. Tried to find a space. Managed to find a space in the one car that... If you guys watch the vlog tomorrow, you'll see what... I boarded, like, one of the cars that was, like... A little bit more roomy and whatnot. Granted, this was, I think, the cafe car, and it's like, ooh, food. I like food. Maybe having train food is not the greatest thing, but, you know. Okay, I just realized something. Can someone tell me if the game is a bit too loud and you guys can't hear me? J-Bunch, thanks for the follow. Hello, J-Bunch. Oh, Jay. Yeah, someone tell me that if my mic is a little bit too low, or I have to move it real, like move my mouth just a wee bit closer. I just moved it a bit closer. Wow, I'm losing gas very fast. Damn truck. So yeah, boarded the train and then was pretty uneventful until I got to second station, and I was like about, I think, 2 stations before mine. Someone apparently boarded the train at the wrong direction, is trying to get back, and I was like, uh-oh, that's not good. And somehow we just managed to kick up a conversation with that person and another person that was on the train, and it like lasted like until the very next stop where both of them got off, and I had to go for one more. Can I go? Oh, okay. Oh, thank you. Give a little toot toot right there. What the? Hey, I was going. Let me go. I'm trying to get my gears going. This turn is so sharp. Damn it, car. Oh, I shouldn't put the higher gear. I'm going up a hill, and this is a heavy, heavy load on this very small truck. So we had a nice conversation. We're talking about, like, just, talking about like how public transportation is actually a really good thing. It was weird that we managed to talk about that, and how it manages to connect people to various different places all around California, which was really, really cool. Because I'm more or less an advocate for public transportation. I am like a nerd, a complete nerd about public transport. Dragon knows this very well. That I really like public transportation, and that was actually a misclick. Yeah, exactly. I'm good at one-on-one stranger talks when it's like just having small talk with someone that's like right there, interact, like more or less interacting with me, or I feel like I should interact with them. It's like, all right, sure, I'll interact with them. But yeah, like with random people that is like in lines, no. That's terrible. So yeah, we were talking about that. Went for like a good 15-20 minutes before they got off at their next stop, and it's like, oh, now the train's quiet. And maybe I should relax for the next few minutes, really, before I get to my transfer point where I get on a different train to get to the city. From there, it was pretty much uneventful. All right, no worries, Jay. Come back anytime when you need to. You're always popping in and out, it's all right. So when I got off the train, I finally got off that train to get into the city, got off that train to get into a bus to get to my school. And I was like thinking, it's like, I'm hoping for the best-ish worst. I know there would be a line, because it's the first day of getting the rentals for cap and gown, and buying if you're planning to buy the cap, or not the cap, the gown. You get to keep the cap, but you don't get to keep the gown. That's a rental. Dang it! I was slowing down at that point in time, and I guess it didn't catch me slowing down. Where was I going? So I was expecting a line, but I didn't expect the line. I expected the line to be no more than an hour, hour and a half at best. This line was long. This line was pretty long. It stretched. It was a pretty much a snake, like a very snake line inside the building, and a long wraparound outside of the building, which I didn't know until I got in. Which the snake part inside I didn't know until I got inside, and I remember hearing a few people saying about it. But I thought, it was like, oh, it's not going to be that bad. Oh, it was bad. snake line, exactly. So I waited there for, like, the first hour, it was fine. It was moving, which was a good thing. Line was, you know, moving at a somewhat decent pace, I'd say. For some people say it's apparently like a Disneyland line. And apparently, some people say it's like a fast pass at a Disneyland line. I haven't been to Disneyland, but so if anyone could vouch for that, if anyone knows the experience of that, that's basically the experience I've experienced. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so I realize it's coming up here in a bit. I was just explaining that. That's like, huh, I realize what you guys said. But yeah. Yeah, it was that bad, to say the least. They had a lot of people for the cash registers-ish. They had about 8 people running the registers. Only 2 people running the rentals, but that line was... were picking up the cap and gown, which is not technically that bad because the line was shorter than the... I'm pretty sure it's about 2 to 2.5 hours waiting. So I didn't experience the line at Disney because we went right when it opened. So, see, that's a smart thing. I got to SF State like 11, and they started the thing around 8. There's no other time I can get there early to wait in line. But I've heard some people waited even 2 hours for waiting around 8 o'clock. So I'm like, oh boy. Excuse me. So I waited there. First hour was okay. I played a little bit of Pokemon Go because that's what I do. Hated someone that tries to keep feeding berries at the Mystic Gym as I was trying to take it down because I'm instinct. Kept feeding berries. I was like, all right, I battled 3 times. I give up. I'll let you have it because you're in line as well for the graduation. I realized that there was the person playing Pokemon Go like a few people ahead of me. It's like, okay, you're playing Pogo too. All right, I'll leave it at that. I'm not going to bother. I don't want to waste too much items, per se. did that. I also did listen, like, catch up on some podcasts and whatnot. So it wasn't as daunting, it was just kind of... eh? I'm pretty sure no one else wanted to be on that line, but they had to be if they wanted to pick it up. Especially for someone like me who had to commute to SF and has to commute back the same day. That's basically the only day I can grab the cap and gown. Ooh, I need to slow down. Helped a group of five take a gym today in the mall. Ooh, nice! Pokemon Go. Wow, that's cool. I wish I could get that kind of help! Wow, this truck took a while to slow down. I'll wait for the car to go forward. Or do I have to go backwards? I might have to go backwards, actually. Okay, there we go. Much better. Damn you, brakes! I need to install the Jake brake button on this controller. Or assign one to it. So yeah, I waited in that line for about 2 hours. I got there at 11. No, not even 2 hours. 2.5. Almost 3 hours. Waited in the big line for about 2 hours because I think I finally finished paying around 2:10 or so. So that would be 3 hours. Oh shit, no, I've been there for 3 hours. Never mind. But 2.5 on the pay line. And then 20 minutes tops on picking up the rental. Realizing I kind of regret not getting the grad pack before then when I went there back in March. But I guess it was worth it. I don't know. There's like some pros and cons to actually getting that grad pack. I realized the big pro in that, getting that grad pack. You basically could just go up, pick it up, and go. Literally. I mean, yeah, but I stopped playing that ages ago. And my internet's really messing up because of the wind outside. Oh, okay. No. Well, if you need to go because of the internet, it's alright. You can go. I know. I will talk with you later. It might rainstorm here in May. That's weird for us. Apparently, it rained up in the Sierras, like, earlier this week. I mean, not earlier this week. Yesterday. Which is, like, technically, it's pretty rare for it to rain up there. During the springtime. Usually it stops raining by, what, March, April? It's May, so I'm like, interesting. I'm fuck. Okay. I'm watching my speed now. So I did that. I grabbed lunch over there at school because I didn't want to make an adventure. I didn't want to make too much of a hassle to find lunch. Over in San Francisco because I had to leave the city by 5 and it was already 2:30. It's been hot and cold here. My allergies are really messing up. Everyone's allergies is messing up. Weirdly enough, not so much when I was in San Francisco, which was great. I missed that city. So I did that and I did a little excursion over at Japantown, finding things over there, whatever I want to try to find. I also grabbed some food, which they're going to be a bonus. There's going to be extra video content in the vlog tomorrow that I'm not going to really explain except saying that I tried to do a food review on the train. You guys have fun watching that. I did have to do a voiceover because I had the other spectrum of awkward talk where I didn't really want to talk because there was people and the train was quiet. And I'm like, I'm doing a voiceover. I'm definitely doing a voiceover. So I did a voiceover on that, but I did try to mouth what I want to say in that video. So have fun if you know how to read my mouth. That would be funny. But yeah, I did a little food review on the train, and hopefully it comes out well. I do wish I could actually talk about it live when I was recording that, but awkwardness came in like a bitch, and that's why. I'm going to do the voiceover. I'm still going to record it, but I'll do a voiceover. Oh, does it have to do with the pic you posted on Twitter? Was it the one where I got a food with a dinner with a view? Pretty much that one, yeah. That was that video. That's going to be in that video. I'm going to grab gas because I think it'll be a great time to grab gas, actually. Oh, shit. I knocked that sign down. And created 1% damage. I think during the time, I'm going to drink some water here. Okay. I want to see this now.
It'll be on the vlog, BRB Twitter check. Go ahead. There's a photo somewhere in there. I know, mini water bottle, right? Wait. Totally not sponsored by Crystal Geyser. Crystal Geyser. It's good water that is not purified, but it's spring water. Like what I have, like Arrowhead spring water. Ta-da! Hashtag not sponsored. Alright, let's get going. Turn on that engine, let's go! Oh fuck, I'm starting on ninth gear. That's probably not the greatest idea ever. Here we go. I realize my game looks a little bit shitty in doing this, but it's okay. We're good. We can get going! Let's move it. So, aside from that, that's what I did on Monday. Finally, I got home around like 7:30. It was weird seeing the sun still around 7:38. It's like, whoa. I'm used to winter when it was already dark by 6 and 7. If I look anything from the ocean to eat, that looks amazing. Oh god, whoa. Right, I'm starting on a high gear. You know, there's a water bottle you can get that tells you and your viewers how much water they should have drank every hour you are alive. Dragon, message me that later in the stream, or after the stream, so I can actually get that bot ready for next week. I will totally want to do that. I would totally do that for the stream, just so I, you know what, I should just do a water, like a drinking challenge, no, a drinking counter, but obviously it's just only water. I would totally do that. Well, yeah, that food was actually pretty good. I got full after eating half of it, though. which kind of sucked, but it's like, oh well. I gave my mom the noodles and the... Oh, what? I said... I gave mom half the food. You guys could figure it out in the vlog later of what I ate. But... Ooh, I'm hitting that lane. Okay. Come on. Just think like you're a nice car and you can actually accelerate at a decent speed. Oh Jesus Christ. You gave your mom nudes, I know. I did. I gave her like half of the food I ate. I ate the other one. I finished two of them and I gave the other one to my mom, which she told me she got a dodgy tummy out of it because it was cold. Sadly, there were no microwaves available on that train or when I bought it because they didn't have it, and the train had microwaves, but it was meant for their food, which makes sense. Jeez, your truck is sliding all over the place. I know, ETS is like a little bit slippery. Oh shit, come on, there we go, much better. Cold half noons, and all of those foods was like not like frozen cold, but like cold to keep, like, you know, like for not in a fridge cold, like a little bit warmer than that, or a little cooler than that, I don't know. You should play GTA 5 and drive a truck for more truck and talk. Izzy, if you give to me GTA 5, sure. Also, I don't know if a MacBook Pro is willing to run GTA 5, but I'm willing to try it out. I don't know, if I do that, I would drive a train. That would be cool if I drive a train. And then hose everyone down. There's so many other games I would want to try, though. Man. I do want to... I'll think about it. I do want to try... It'll be tricky to do Cluster Truck for an hour and a half to 2 hours, though, considering what I'm thinking, but I might do it for, like, a beginning thing and then jump onto, like, ATS or ETS2. I'll family share it. Oh, boy. Oh, no. Oh, no. Computer, I guess I could do it. Nah. I'll think about it. Aside from that, let's see, was the rest of the week uneventful? Pretty much. I ran a bunch of errands earlier yesterday and then streamed with Dragon with a little bit of Overwatch. If you count 4 hours, a little bit of Overwatch, that was a little bit of Overwatch. Aside from that, I pretty much stayed home, and whatnot. Pretty much, I'm just waiting for next week, which got, I'll say this again, coming up to this week. Next week, I am not doing Truck and Talk Thursdays. I will be out of town in San Francisco next week for graduation. So there will be no Truck and Talk Thursdays. I'll continue Truck and Talk Thursdays the following Thursday, which I think is June, I think. No. 24th plus 7. 31st. So actually, I'm still going to have one more stream in May. So I will be streaming on the 31st of May, not next week. So yeah. If you notice that there is no Truck and Talk Thursdays on, if I'm not streaming next week, you know why. And if there's no Truck and Talk Thursday VODs, which I put it up on YouTube every following Tuesday, every Tuesday after the Thursday stream. I think that's how I could word it. But every Tuesday I have the VOD. I put it up on YouTube just in case if someone misses the Truck and Talk Thursday stream. I mean, sure, you can watch it here on Twitch. It'll probably be in my video section because I do keep recorded videos for a little bit. I do have it up there permanently on YouTube for those who just wants to watch it. I know there's a few people that would want to watch it, so yeah. Aside from that, my week is pretty uneventful, and that's what's going to be happening next week. I can't wait. I'm going to be leaving Wednesday. I'm going to be staying over in San Francisco with the family for 2 nights. Come back Friday. Probably be exhausted. I'm happy that I finally finished. Even though I technically have my degree here, I watch them even though I'm in. I'm cuz lame. Aw, Dragon. Well, I mean, for some facts, you do actually miss some of it, so it makes sense, in a way. what else was I going to say? There's one thing I do want to hopefully it's a wonder after this end of the stream if I'm going to be now aiming for affiliate status, because I do technically now have to meet 3 average viewers, which I think I'm meeting right now, looking at the numbers being slowly updated here and there. On the very top left of the screen, I'm pointing the wrong way, and I don't think I'm pointing that way. Oh god, I hate pointing. Remember, it's like over there somewhere. It says I'm holding 6, but that number updates very slowly. But I'm also gonna set up maybe a daily follower goal. I've heard this from like other people, like a handful of people, that if you want to keep growing your Twitch channel, which I want to try a little bit, you want to always set daily goals to hopefully see if you can hit it every day. So hopefully I could, you know, grow a little bit by doing this. I mean, it's not much, but it's worth a shot. I like to rewatch our Squid Against Humanity videos, lol. Now let's do more call for YouTube. One day. Yeah. Sadly, I need to... Shit, I haven't edited... No, I have edited those. No, I haven't. Yes, I have. I've edited the stupid takes of the Cards Against Humanity sessions, I think. Yeah, I'm making a special episode, do it IRL and upload it to YouTube. I want to do... Okay. So... On one of the vlogs that I did earlier this year, there was a birthday party I attended, Izzy attended, and Brianna having. It was Brianna's birthday party. I wanted to actually record a live session of Kaw, even if it was a 10-minute snippet. But Dirt Me didn't bring a full tripod to hang over the table, and it's like probably not the smartest idea because there's actually a lot of people around there, and I don't want people knocking over the tripod, which handles my slightly expensive DSLR camera, and that's what I was planning to record it on. But yeah, I wanted to do a live session there. I thought it would be cool doing just a impromptu live session of Cards Against Humanity, but it kind of failed, and I kind of just put the camera away, except for like 1 or 2 points. Or sub smash. Ooh, maybe. I'll think about it. Oh yeah, yeah, it was really loud. But I was like, I tried. I thought it would work out. Oh, I do need to merge in this lane. Merge, 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 merge.
There we go, much better. But one day I do want to do a live session of, like an in real life session of Cards Against Humanity. I would need a camera that can record more than 10 minutes aside from my phone. As much as I would want to record on my phone. No, I can only do 10 minutes on my phone as well. Fuck. I could bring this webcam and my laptop and then I run out of space. Maybe. I'll try not to get another foot cramp. Right, that did happen. Well, I need to figure it out. I eventually should get maybe a camcorder? I don't know. Or a camera that can at least record up to 30 minutes so I can at least record all that shtick. That was funny, though, the foot cramp. I remember taking a picture of that foot cramp and posting it on Twitter. That was hilarious. Man, I wish I could set up a goal to actually get a new camera. That would be cool. That would require probably a little bit too much effort. Or not. I don't know. I'm thinking this all in my head to see if it's actually doable and if I don't feel guilty about it. That's been slightly my problem. I don't want to feel guilty if I actually do something like that. So. One of my relatives still thought I was doing ukulele in pain. Oh no. Huh. To be fair, you did look like you were doing yoga, so yeah. It's not that much effort, but guilt sucks.
Yeah.
I think it's definitely more guilt over effort. Cause, I mean, there's people that's willing to give money away, but if I feel weird if it's like if they're gonna be expecting more. Cause I have technically went through this at one point in time where I actually set up a that was close. I did set up a PayPal link back like 6 years ago, I think. BRB real quick, family zone for the first time in 5 days. Oh boy, alright, go ahead, Dragon. Take your time. I did set up a PayPal link because I was back when Minecraft was really big of a thing. Granted, Minecraft is still kind of big of a thing. I did try to run a Minecraft server at one point. It lasted for, like, with a group of friends. It lasted for about 5 months. It was, if Dragon was still here, she would know what kind of server I built. She would know what server I built. But it's, has magic plugins. It has a bunch of plugins. Magic, economy, and all that stuff, because one of my friends wanted to do it as a magic server because they knew the magic spells plugin. If anyone knows about that, cool. I'm not going to go into great detail on that. I wanted to do an economy server because I played on, like, those kinds of servers back then. I was like, oh, this will be cool. And do ranks and all that stuff. But mainly it was more magic based, to say the least. But I remember running that server, being the admin, trying to run that whole thing, renting a server to run a Minecraft server. There we go. I can't fuck. Words. Slow down. So yeah, I tried to run a Minecraft server, which it worked. Apparently, I remember having few online players at times. Remember running that server up to, like, I don't know, like 70 people at one point, which is actually pretty decent for, like, a very small server. I made that turn like a bitch, but I made it. But yeah, I remember that was a hassle, and running a Minecraft server on a very small college budget was probably not the smartest thing ever. So I did end up asking for some help and donations at one point. And some people did donate, but one of them, like, expected more out of it, even though I've listed there that this is all I allow. This is what I'm going to allow. No one gets a free pass on anything, even though I did have some friends that actually tried to give free passes to other people. It's like, I don't know how to regulate this per se, because they're my friends, to say the least. I mean, I don't talk to them now because they're doing their own shtick, but I remember that was happening, and I think one of them disputed about it all the way up to PayPal requesting a refund, and man, that costs so much money when you have to do a dispute. It sucks. But it happens at times, so I guess, you know, that's what happens. Oh, shit. Oh, really? It required me to park it all in the corner? Oh, damn these nuts. I'm gonna go the easy way. Can I make this turn? Look at that, I'm making the turn! Hell yeah! Yeah, fuck that. I'm gonna make a U-turn back. Or actually, you know what? Fuck it. Sorry, I'm in a hurry now. Skip. So I've always had a guilt to start something like that because I don't want people to do chargebacks and whatnot. I mean, I guess I could do it on GoFundMe or something like that, but that's still. let's save this. I'm gonna grab another external contract as we go by. Job market. Okay, here we go. So I always have guilt if I ever get money from random people, which it hasn't happened yet, so, or lately, so I guess that's a good thing, but I will have that kind of guilt once it comes in. I do technically have a donate button down in the information below, just there optionally, because why not? Jesse Games, thank you for the follow. Welcome to Joker Talk Thursdays as well. Okay, where am I going? So yeah, I just still have a little guilt if I ever get money from people. Oh geez, what have I not explored in Europe? I know there's some roads I haven't explored, but I have no idea how the fuck I'm gonna do that. I don't know how I missed this. Apparently they built it. Oh, I can go to Dortmund. Oh god, what did I do to Paris? Oh god, what did you do to Paris? Holy shit. Holy shit. Wow, that's huge, actually. Innsbruck. Let's see. Okay. What do they got me to do? I want to stay on the east side of Europe. I'm almost close to Russia, the Slavic. No, yeah, Russia, actually. Because I see Poland right there. I could go to Sweden. Sweden. I thought I said sweat then. That was weird. Okay, hold on. I want to figure out where I want to go, but I don't know where I want to go. I still want to see if there's an Innsbruck one. Apparently, I don't know how I missed Innsbruck, but apparently missed Innsbruck. But I was right here. Sweden. Okay, fine. Let's go to Sweden. External contracts. I've been there already. Ooh, I want to travel that eastern seaboard route. Okay, sure, why not? Begin the delivery! Oh, there's my foot! So yeah, that's been happening this week. That's what I've been talking about. Is there any other... Sweet 10. Sweet and low. There it is. Is there any topics that you guys want to talk about? Talk about your week or if anything? You could share it out here. There's no problem to that. Why is my parking brake on? What the fuck? If you want to talk about your week or of any topic that you have in mind, go ahead. We can try and talk about it. Aside from politics and religion, I want to stay away from those subjects as best as we can. Great. I'm going to go the long way. Long way time! Oh, God! Backing up. Going forward. So yeah, if you have any topics, say it out there. I'm trying to see if I can think of anything aside from having guilt with donors, but I'll think about it. I kind of want to get a new camera one day. We'll see. Aw, damn it! Same old, except now I'm knee-deep in Sword Boys. Oh yeah, I remembered you got some new cards for that dang flabbit card game called Card Fight Vanguard. Jesus Christ, that was a weird way to say it. Come on, light change, yes! Fuck yeah, drifted. I'm gonna see. I wish I could drift on the truck, but I'm gonna tip it. Oh yeah, look at that. I could do it. Oh shit. 70 kilometers an hour. I'm a beast. That's not the popo. Oh Jesus, that didn't work. I got that grade 3 of the unit you hate. Oh no. Oh great. That's fun. Thanks. Ooh, dang. This has nice braking, though. When it doesn't have a load. Ooh, you ran a red light. I kill you. Come back here. I will get you. Okay, I'm gonna do something dumb. Whee! This is so stupid. Fuck. 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 I feel sad for anyone that drives this truck and then tries to brake like that. Jesus Christ, the amount of G's you get on that thing. I didn't... I know, right? He's a bad boy. I was a badder boy by overtaking him on a solid. I'm a great person when I drive. Fuck. Alright. Let's see. Okay, so we're going to Sweden. Man, I want to go to Europe one day. I know Dragon is going to the UK, maybe she'll be my excuse to go around to places in Europe after that. Oh, but that would be cool though, nonetheless. Come on. Ninth gear! We could do this, bitches! Ooh. Oh god, that's curb. Oh god, that's a sign. Alright, let's not hit anything. There we go, much better. Ooh, I crossed the line, but they didn't catch me. That's cool. Want to go for France for Frass? For the art and bread? Yeah, they do. Oh, I actually want to I wonder if there's a technical difference between a croissant in France and a croissant anywhere else. Granted, if that's actually such a thing in the first place. Dang it, I thought I slowed down fast. Oh, I got caught by the popo. France. I've always wanted to try out the flaky death. That is the croissant! I was trying to figure out where that was because I wanted to speed up. Why did you keep it at 50 kilometers an hour even though we're outside the city limits? Well, now we're outside the city limits. I can speak the English in the Europe's. Swing that car, swing that truck round and round and just speed up the fuck out of it. Weehee! Silly limit. Nope, that's not my turn. I thought I was about to turn right there. But yeah, I want to go like, France is one thing. France, maybe. I still hear some bad shit going down, like terrorists and whatnot, but I'm not going to say too much about it. It's a nice city. It's not a nice city. It's a nice place. Nice country. One day I want to visit it. Ooh, nailed that corner like a bitch. Ooh. Oh, almost drifted it. Oh, I should have drifted it. Okay, let's go. Let's do this. Oh my god, I hear farm animals. I'm picking up farm stuff, I think. I forgot what I was picking up, actually. Was it eggs? Hold on, let me check. Oh, yeah, sliding in, boys. What am I picking up? Tomatoes! I'm driving tomatoes all the way to Sweden. But those are not meant for your Swedish meatballs, Sweden. Why do you need tomatoes? I think they have tomato dishes, actually. Do you want to go there? I actually kind of do want to go to Sweden. Be fun. I heard a lot of good things about that place. Switzerland too, cause chocolate. Germany, cause, well, anything that actually probably has access to, like, I still, like, within Europe, I would wanna ride their high-speed trains because I'm a train nerd and I am like that kind of person. I would like to ride the Intercity Express from Germany, God, I can't remember the France one. TGV? I forget the name. I forget the name of their high speed. Eurostar to get between France and France and the United Kingdom for a little bit more than your for an airplane fare, I think. That's what I've heard. But hey, taking a train down the channel, down the channel tunnel. I would totally do that, actually, though. I'm gonna get hit, aren't I? Sorry, RV, I didn't mean to go straight ahead. I mean, it's not like I do that when I ride Amtrak or BART. So, yes, I do listen to that opening of that show and have fun with it.
Oh, come on, let's accelerate the fuck.
Look at that sunset. Damn it, I put rider. That's rider. Ha! Rip. Damn you, instinct. Or consciousness. Instinct. Damn instinct. Ooh, okay. Come on, rev up. I'm fucked. Come on, here we go. I realize we have actually 1,347 kilometer journey, which will take 27 hours and 20 minutes, which should take about 1 hour in real time. So hopefully I can finish it in like, then. I realize I can't really speed up max of, can't speed past 90 kilometers an hour because that's a hard limit on external contracts, which is weird. Instinct, gotta love it and hate it. Yeah, that's definitely true. Sometimes you love it because, hey, it works out in the end, right? It's like, oh, hey, I just say it and it just happens. But then after that, you just say it and it just happens and you realize that's not what you wanted to say in the first place. And it's like, fuck. Oof. Actually, I just keep it at that speed. Oh, let me keep it at that speed. Let me keep it at 10th gear and cruise control, baby. I might need to get gas soon, apparently. Okay, what's my route? What's my route of choice today? I'm getting off the highway and going down the beaten path. Somewhere down that way, and then now up that road, and then going that road, and taking that road, and we're going to get to Gdansk. I read that as Gdansk. Did I get a message? Because I heard my phone go off. Okay. What happens if I want to go the other way? What happens if I actually want to go this way? This actually looks really cool. 28 hours versus... I fucked up. 27. It takes another hour. I think I got time. Let me explore that road. Can pass through this little small town. That'd be cool. That is a lot of roads. But I'm trying to figure out what kind of path I want to take. Because I still got... In real time... It says 2 hours and 21 minutes, but that's 2 hours and 21 minutes real time. Because it's an external contract. It's a contract where anyone that owns this game that wants to do the same exact route as I'm doing right now can take it. Which is pretty cool. Oh, I think that's what they added for 1.3.1. I'm almost off my lane. Whoops. Also, welcome back, Dragon. Welcome back to Trucker Talk Thursdays. I kind of ran out of topics to talk about, aside from talking about where I want to go in Europe and ride all the trains around in Europe. So if you got anything you want to talk about, I'm trying to get into one lane. Anything you want to talk about, say it out there, because I now can't think of any other topics in my head right now. Ooh, fuck, 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 fuck. Look at that speed. I went a whole whopping 9 kilometers an hour down that way. All right, that's true. I've been hearing you're doing quite a lot of D&D, realizing it. He's just going in between the lanes because he's the only one there. Shh. It is so bad. Bad, I meant. Now I'm going to do as what other distracted drivers do, and oh my god, this is going to be tricky. Glad to know I used that. Whoop. Is my... Oh, I turned it off! I was coasting the whole time. Okay, that's beautiful. There we go.
I thought I could able to do that. It went all the way in the end, and until I realized I turned off my own engine. Whoops. Shh. Okay. Dang it, I did it again. Did I set cruise control or not? Okay, there's cruise control off. Okay. Alright, anyway, sorry. Do I talk about D&D and stream all your chat, though? It's alright, it's fine, I'm curious. I knew you were planning to talk about it, so I was actually pretty curious about it. Go ahead. Curious. There's people here, spam help. It's at least the people that you don't know is gonna be in your campaign, though, if you think about it. No. Oh, I hate you so much, fifth fan. I mean, if the other mods tells you to do it, who is Tissue, do it. Ooh, bus is gonna actually get some gas. Jay went and streamed. Okay, so. All right. Okay. So dun dun dun.
Story time with Dragon.
Drive in the night, actually, this would be cool story time. I've been asked to DM with one shot. Oh, that's gonna be cool. And like, how long have you played D&D? Like, I know if you only played for like a few months, but DMing it like straight there, that's pretty cool. To say the least, like, that's honestly, if I think about it, an honor to actually DM a game. Well, I mean, yeah, sure, it's a one shot, but still, you're DMing one game. So for someone who has just gotten into D&D actively for a few months, I think basically the story that I created is that the chiefess of a small elven village made a call to all adventurers to help her find a solution to her problem.
Ooh.
That's a premise right there. Okay, not full premise, but premise nonetheless. I read that as tab taxi. Cab taxi, that goddamn it. Tabaxi? I hope I'm pronouncing that right. They made a treaty with the taxi cab people and then being dangerous. Oh dear. Well, ain't that a broke to an agreement. There we go. Taxi leaders and everyone they sent out doesn't come back. Oh no. Well, that sounds like death in a process. So their adventures have to all get together and figure out things on the. Oh wow, that's pretty cool. And this is where you start the adventure. That's what happens when you misread one thing. By complete accident. Ooh, the light's green. Oh, but that sounds like a actually pretty good story. But hearing that no one else has returned seems a bit daunting. Now, I mean, I don't want you to spoil what you're planning to do. Because sounds like it could be a really interesting story. And DM, check it. And you've been playing for a year and a bit. Okay. Attack of the Puss People. They want to kill all the other races because they are inferior to the cat people. The Puss People. Actually, I call it curiosity killed. Oh, but did they get 9 lives?
I wouldn't make that joke. Oh, that's funny. Now that's a pun. Ooh, bridge. Not all of them are dead, but some are the important ones. Oh no. Oh no. So every person, I feel like that every person they want to talk to, they're dead! Maybe. Quote unquote. Dun dun dun. Can I get through? I know you can hear my I'm in a predicament that I don't want to be. Can I get through? Can I get through? Fuck. Fuck. Do you want to tell you what's actually going on? That's something now I'm kind of being iffy about, because it's like, I guess if there's a more of a premise you want to say, you can. Oh shit. But I guess don't. I literally held my breath. Obviously it's all gonna depend on how the players play it, right? So if you can try to give like a general premise of how the whole game would be played out, without maybe spoiling it to you. I don't know. Cause granted, I'm not playing. Fuck. Come on now. There we go. So. Yeah, I'd say give a... Assuming that they're not here. You're up to give a general premise of how this storyline will run. I guess. Sorry. I realized you were typing then. Because I got distracted by cars. Okay, well, let's just say there are these things that were exiled from a thing. And that they are mad about it. And are using things to get back the thing. Ooh. So we must get this really important thing back from them, I think. Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, I see what you mean. These things that works out from a thing. Different. So it sounds like, yeah, I did. I'm trying to reread it. I'm trying to piece it together. So they're using it as an act of... Okay, so while I'm rereading it as... they're using it as an act of revenge. Oh, shit. Ooh, this is... Whoa. I hate being next to many trucks. Fuck me. I'm assuming them using the heroes, I guess, not the enemy. Alright, Brianna, have fun. Take your time. They're using the Tabaxis. Okay. To get back at them, I'm assuming, or... This is what happens when I accidentally try to overpiece a bunch of things. Whoops. Lublin. It's like Dublin, but lubbing. Don't quote that. That's a terrible quote. The exile things are using the Tabaxis so they can get back at the thing that exiled them. Oh, okay. Huh, interesting. Ooh. It's a wonder if it'll actually work out well. It's a wonder if they're gonna get a happy ending or death. That Lublin comment, yes. Manipulation, wow. Please don't clip that. Stupid comment that I made though. Ooh. Man, I hope a good battle with that then. That would be interesting. I wonder how far they have to get there, actually, to actually do it. And hopefully, to wonder if there's, like, uptime. I don't think I have set that up. Nope, I did not set that up. But if you're wondering how long I've been going on, from what OBS is telling me, it's 1:10. Realizing it's already 8. How long have you been live? So, yeah, we're going for about 1:10. This is going to be the last load. I've taken 2 long loads today, this time around. I want to go back and clip that. I think you're probably around like 1:06, so yeah. There's your time of reference. Alright, let's keep going. But that sounds like fun. Well, hopefully your adventurers will have an adventurous time, and hopefully they don't die easily, per se. But I'm assuming, are you going to go for, like, I'm curious, are you planning to have them be free at the end of the one shot? Be dead? Or don't tell at all, because that's a major, major surprise. Which you don't have to. God, this is so risky. I am hoping they kill things manipulating. Kill the things manipulating. Oh, okay, I see. Ooh. So if it's like, if they don't, they would mess with me. Would mess with me if they help the things instead of kill them. I'm assuming there's gonna be a major consequence if they actually don't kill those manipulators. Saying, oh, they're gonna, in like in a one shot end, they'd be like, oh, because you didn't kill them, they kill you instead. Ooh. That would be a whole new story. Oh, okay. I got you. Yes, there will be. Okay. Ooh. That sounds like fun. That's pretty cool. Oh, okay. Oops. It's a wonder. That's gonna be interesting. It's a wonder what they're actually gonna plan on doing. The village people and gnolls, they would have to kill them after. Close to them. Oh. Damn, that's dark. I see. Ooh. Jesus Christ, that's a short... Wow, you gave me no space for that. Because I mean that way. I mean, hey, if it's betrayal, and they know it's... The whole township knows it's betrayal, that definitely requires death. Dun dun dun. Exactly all the dun dun dun. Alright, let's get there. Alright, let me drift turn this shit. Oh yeah, fuck. That's police. That's the polezi. And I'm stuck on 10th gear, trying to get up back to speed. This is awkward! Awkward! Made it. But, ooh, you know what? That sounds like a pretty solid story. Mind the middle part, because that's what the adventurers are planning to do. But nonetheless, that's a pretty good story. Because if you don't follow through your actions, there will be consequences. Which makes sense. Fuck me. I wanna get in, truck. Now, long did it take you to write that story? I'm actually curious. No. Turn right about. Damn it. Oh, Trent, don't hit me. I hate you too! I'm stuck on like 10th gear right now. Shit. Truck sounds rough. One day of writing, one day of making characters and name settings, one day of R20 setup. Wow. Wow, that's pretty cool. For one shot, that's pretty cool. It's a wonder, though, after, I guess, doing this, and I know you have a couple of other D&D sessions rolling in soon for yourself, your DM sessions rolling in soon. So wonder if you're ever going to do like a continuous D&D session one day. Do you plan on like DMing for a whole series, actually? I think about it, that's a series. Can I make the turn without having a problem? Oh yeah, look at that, 9 kilometers turn. Woohoo! Hell yeah! Oh my god, it's so dark behind me. I can't see anything, you guys can't see anything, we're all fucked. Would love to. Oh, true. I'm pretty sure one day you're gonna have the time to actually do that. Of who, you know, with whoever, whenever, right? I mean, you should keep that as a bucket list thing. Like, host a D&D series. Having a job, not having a job, moving to England, starting life over in a new country, it's hard. Yeah, I know. You have a lot of prospects in you. Coming up in this next few months, which, oh my god, excited, but it's equally terrifying. I would see that. I could kind of feel it because I've been through that ish. I mean, not as big of a move like going from to a different continent, but just moving out in general, yeah. It's a daunting task, but all the best for that. Ooh, train! Anyways. So, right. Once you got your graduation coming up as well. Actually, you know what? Since I was talking about when I got my cap and gown, when are you planning to get yours? And I think you probably have reserved it or something. And goodbye parties. Aww. The feels will be real this year. Aww. Oh no. At least it'll be happy sad feels, not bitter sad feels, I guess. Oh, ew, right, ew. Ew. Ew! It's terrible, right, I forgot it was that. Oh god. Oh no. Can I do it? I'm gonna fucking do it! That means, I think you have like, what, how many students? Like 40,000 students? You divide that by 4-ish. That means roughly 10,000 students is planning to pick up their cap and gown on the same goddamn day. Ew. Thank god we had 10 days to pick it up. So maybe my complaint for the Disneyland World line will not be as so bad if it takes longer than 3 hours. Damn, that sucks. No, we divide that by more. There's more than 4 faculties down. Okay. Well, I was thinking, I thought it was, like, gonna be for, like, a general line to pick up cap and gown and all that stuff. I didn't expect to be, like, split within your, like, maybe your divisions or something like that. Because us, it was, like, 10 days spread through amongst general graduation. Like, general graduates. I mean, sure, we have our own school of blank, but they don't do the regalia. The school does, and it's like, why? These are long lines, and no. Oh, okay. You know, we have, like, I mean, we do have separate convocations as well, but we also have that big, big general one, which is being hosted in AT&T Park. Which my parents are being a bit iffy about because they don't want to be there a while because they're old people and they don't want to stand there. I mean, I'm gonna aim for going for the convocation for computer science. I know that's gonna be a thing. Hell, hosted on the same day. Oh, really? Interesting. I did not know you guys actually not have a general graduation, or general commencement. That's interesting to know. Huh. Noted. Yeah, because we have our general one, but it's optional for anyone to attend. I have tickets for it, just in case if my parents did want to attend it anyways. But I've been hearing they don't want to, so... And I've heard other people are planning not to do the general commencement either. Even though it is at AT&T Park, and I haven't really been there, but I'll respect my parents because they are pretty old. And they have a bit of issues when it comes to sitting down on long things, for like long presentations, all that stuff, so I'll respect them. But I think, yeah, my parents really just want to go for the smaller one, so it'll be easier to like take pictures and do all that stuff. So, okay, I'll do that. Oh, yeah, no, even for us, we couldn't do it in our own, like, halls and whatnot. Ours is going to be where the San Francisco Giants play, is at AT&T Park. Literally, that whole stadium is closed down for one day for about 5,000 to 8,000 graduates, I'd say. So that's going to be quite the interesting moment if me and my parents do end up going there. And other people if I end up inviting other people. Oh, really? Like, not even U of A could actually rent out the stadium if needed? Oh, I see. I mean, I guess they don't have a game on Thursday. No, the Giants sometimes have a game on Thursday, but I guess they reschedule for a different day because of it. I don't know. I'm not into much of that baseball. Oh no, it's spring training. Right, there's actually no legit. See, it's not yet. Is it already in season for baseball? Or is it still spring training? I can't remember right now. I don't follow baseball lately. All right. Because we ended February, which sometimes they play in the snow in Super Bowl. Really? Why is it only 70 down this way? There we go. I don't know shit about baseball. Well, it was worth a shot. Sorry, but fuck me. The bus right next to me. Please go. Please go. We're getting close to this. I'm gonna back off. Doing this at 90k. Kind of nervous about grad, by the way. Aww. You do have other family that wants to attend, huh? I think, if I remember correctly. Or is it not that? I don't know. Ooh, I need to grab gas again. Jesus Christ, me. Okay, where am I now, actually? Am I getting close? Oh, nope, I still got two cities to go. Okay, yeah, I should be ending roughly around that point. Alright, let's get it. I mean, it's weird that I'm not really stressing about graduation. Again, maybe because I already have my degree, and I'm just attending this just to meet up with people one last time, hopefully. Family, being around a bunch of people, talking about GPA again. I mean, the good thing is that you've passed. You've graduated. Like that's really the big thing. And you've already have work experience, which is, like, hell of a lot more than GPA. I mean, if you have gotten... Because I don't want the pity speeches. Oh, jeez. Like, you've done a lot more work and probably have done a lot more than any other high GPA person that has no experience in whatever. I don't think they're that... Okay. See, I haven't been to, like, a true university commencement, even if it's within the major. I feel like they shouldn't do that unless if you graduate with high honors. Usually they'll say... Like, with high honors, higher honors, highest honors, like that. But I don't think they would necessarily say the whole GPA number. They probably will call out your name, and if you don't receive the high honors, you don't get the high honors statement. Because I don't even know if your school does... I mean, none of the schools here, technically, aside from, I think, Ivy Leagues, does the cum laude, magna cum laude, summa cum laude, like that. With honors, higher honors, and highest honors. So they shouldn't... I don't think they're gonna say the GPA, because technically, more or less, that's confidential, if you think about it. Because that pertains on how well you are in the subject, but that doesn't... Like, if you say high honors, there's some ambiguity into it. With saying the GPA number, it's so specific that it could be damaging to people to hear what kind of GPA you do have in the first place. So I feel like that was not going to happen. Also, I'm not going to my certificate convocation, so I hope they send that shit to me. Hopefully they do too. I'm pretty sure they should. You want your fancy certificate and your degree. I hope the degree is gonna... I hope your degree is better than being on 8x4 or 8x11 A4 cardstock with fancy font printed but not embossed in it. Certificate. Oh, I've always liked to get that certificate. I wish I know what a certificate is, though. That'll be cool to know. I'm gonna coast it. Fuck this light. It's gonna go that. We're gonna do the thing, isn't it? There we go. Much better. Yeah, like, I remember when I got my degree, it's like, why does it look slightly cheap? I mean, granted, I don't have the booklet that the degree usually comes in. They just sent out my degree. Technically, I'm supposed to pick up that booklet in the general commencement. What happens if I don't want to go there? What happens? Can I just ship out the book? Oh, really? Fuck me. Can I just ship out the book instead? I forgot what it's called, actually. Where you get to keep your degree in. And technically, my parents was trying to look for a frame to put my degree in. General booklet? Like, the... I hope I still have it in here. For my high school. Are you in here? I'm gonna have to get through more things if I can't find it in, like, 2 steps. Okay, I'm not gonna try and show it because I don't know where it is specifically. But it's like a cover. But it's like a book cover to keep your diploma or degree in.
I'm also gonna close my window because it's already 8:30.
I think
it's 8:30. It's 8:30, wow. You want the fanciest freaking frame? Did you order a frame? Curious about that. Wee, let's go. Let's go, bitches! I guess I can't really speed now. No? Aw, I see. I know what is money? Oh, right, true. Right. Fuck. What is life? Aw. Life is where you have fun because you only live once. That's what many other people say. But, no. I know my parents actually has like a frame lying around somewhere. Sure, it's a picture frame, but you know, it works out, right? It'd be cool to have one of those fancy frames, but I could use I could use money and other things than a frame per se. Yeah. I will believe in that one settled in England. There we go. Alright. Ooh. I am so gassy tonight. I'm gassy any night, what I'm talking about. Did I eat beans? I'm out of eat beans. That's why I'm so gassy. Dad, I'm a badass. I can actually drive straight. Oh, fuck. Ooh. That's gonna be interesting. Ooh, nice. Do you know any information of, like, your flatmate? Hashtag, there it is, yes. Because that sounds like fun. That's going to be fun to hear out. Damn it, no. Fuck. Oh, okay. Oh, that sounds like fun. Sounds like a person you could definitely connect to. Fuck me, I'm gonna try and do it anyways. It's gonna suck, but I will do it. I could've waited like about a few more seconds, I think. Nope. But so far, golden. Dang, that's pretty cool. So she's been there for, like, I guess... Oh, I mean, I guess you don't know too much of her, right? Of, like, background and whatnot, except that. I should have passed. Well, that sounds like fun. I just hope she likes you. Yeah, that's always the fun part. To figure out if they like you or not. Hopefully. She's moving there the first time, like, oh, I see, okay. So you guys, it's both of your guys' first times. Ooh. Yeah, definitely. I hope she likes you as well. But sounds like you share enough common interests for it. Also, Izzy, someone in League thinks I'm scripting. Lol, rip. I hope they don't ban you. Whew. Is she also from Canada? Nah, I should probably ask that question. Or, like, some other place? Or don't know about that one. She is nervous about the big city life. She hopes living in Toronto this summer will help with the London life. Ooh, interesting. They are roughly the same, I think. That answered your question. Ta-da! Oh god.
But ooh, I'm thinking Toronto is could be considered as a very it's an urban city. It has its mass transit, so it could be like a London. Could deal with urban life like that. Yeah. Definitely London's smaller, but. I think London beats Papa definitely though.
Yeah.
London is definitely more urban. No matter which direction you go. I mean, Toronto has its urban spots, but it's pretty. I think it's a little bit more sparsely populated. Like, in terms of, like, urban concentration, definitely London has that. I think Toronto kind of has it, but there's definitely a big suburbs. And a little less urban, I think. Oh shit. Edmund is a baby. Yeah, I could see that actually. Because, like, the closest comparison to London in terms of North America, I'd say, is definitely New York, in terms of its urban sprawl. San Francisco, if within the city of San Francisco, it could be considered the very small version of that, more or less. Because that has a urban feel in a suburban, in some suburban environment, times. I know LA is probably closer to Toronto, Edmonton, like other very big cities. Seattle and Portland might be exceptions, I think, as well. Boston exception, and like that. All of Canada's population freaking lives in London. Oh God. It's weird. Are they, like, more accepted there or something? That's interesting to know. Than anywhere else in England? I mean, sure, there will be a heavy accent. Heavy accent the more north you go. But that's how it usually is. No, OMG. I don't know. Like, my thinking is, like, there's, like, not much people. Like, if you go outside of maybe, like, the very big hubs, like, I guess, London, maybe Birmingham, Manchester as well? I don't know. I kind of just, like, tried to figure out what I was trying to talk about, and I kind of lost myself as well. Maybe they just accept London easier than other cities? I don't know. I'm stuck behind a slow truck for a little bit. You mentioned more accepted there. I don't know, like, my thought, that's what I'm speculating. I don't know if that's true, like, saying it's, like, it's easier to be around with the people in London rather than being, that's not a smart idea. With the people in London than, say, people in, like, other big cities in the UK, I guess? I don't know. Yeah. Or maybe they just wanted to be in that city. Jesus Christ, that's 3 for 3 now. Yeah, that's definitely true. I'm just making presumptions. I'm just making assumptions as to why they would choose London over anything else, over any other city. Better not whack me, you bud. Ooh, someone building a big freeway up here. About what? Who is they? No, because I don't know if I misread that when you said all of Canada's population freaking lives in London. So I'm assuming that every Canadian, if planning to live in the UK, chooses London. And my thought was, like, maybe they like London over any other city? I don't know. I'm passing, like, the worst section ever. Damn it, car, you make me want to pass, and I pass in the wrong section. Thank you. So, I don't know. I probably definitely misread that part. Oh, numbers wise. Oh, okay. Oh, okay, that makes a lot more sense now. Really? London has a metro population of 34 million? Damn. That's crazy. That's even bigger than New York, I think. That's what I assumed you said. Whoops, sorry, Dragon. Well, that was an interesting, awkward conversation right there, in a nutshell. Okay, I see what you mean now. I definitely see what you mean now. Okay. I did not know London actually has a metro population of 34 million. Damn. That's even, I think, bigger than LA. New York, I think? New York might... No, New York... has less than London. I thought you meant figuratively, whoopsies. London having a metro population of 34 million. Damn, that's super dense, though. Oh, everyone does live in London. More or less, everyone does live in London. Jesus Christ. Granted, how many people actually live in the UK? I guess I should get that number as well. I muted?
Hello?
Ooh, that's almost an accident right there. Am I still muted? My mic go crap? Oh, okay. Jesus Christ. Well, that was like 34 mil in the London Metro. Damn. England has 53.5. Okay. For a small island. Damn. Island country. Well, relative. That's damn. Wait, I just realized that's only England. That doesn't include, that's not the whole United Kingdom. But still, that's still a lot of people. If it's whole of United Kingdom or England, that's still a lot of people nonetheless. I can't hear you. Damn it! Even if my mic is here, this mic is so quiet. Hold on. Let me move my mic closer this way. There we go. Much better. I think the game is still, yeah, the game is definitely louder than the thing. Hold on. Realizing it now.
Hello?
I'm gonna lower that. Let's see if I could hear myself. I could hear myself. I think something went wrong on your thing, because I can hear myself. Because I played my stream and I think it might be you.
Because I looked at it, it's like, I hear myself. Maybe you move something. So move something around and it kind of borked something. Does happen. But thank you for that audio check. I actually did need that. Because I wasn't so sure myself. Huh. Oh no, I hope your headphones are not dead. That would not be good. Why me? Aww. Did it somehow break again? Aw, it's alright. I realized I should actually, I mean, I needed to do an audio check if other people could like vouch for me with that, I would believe it, but since it's only us two and three other people that are watching it, I have to do the audio check, which is okay. I'm okay with that. Wanted to be sure. I think we're almost there. We're 500 kilometers away, and I do have a ferry ride and then a short drive after that. So I think we're almost to our port to go to back to Sweden, because Brianna suggested to go to Sweden, and I was like, all right, let's go to Sweden. Sweden, home of the IKEA and the meatballs. And the fuck. Ooh, it's a Rooney boot. Okay. There we go. Alright, let's make this. Ooh, another roundabout. Ooh, what places? I know you, I've seen some photos and heard some things that you went over to your biggest mall in North America, West Edmonton Mall. Applied to places. I know you printed out some resumes last night. That's a wonder where you applied. Is there any cool places? Really, really cool places? I almost made an accent right there. Got into an accident, not made an accident. Jesus Christ, Earl. Why are you still in the lane? Asshole. If you're gonna stay. Wow, really? I was going to merge in already. Coming like a wrecking ball. I had to pay it all. I'm lost. Fuck. Places to make routines. Ooh, you get to now be a poutine master like you had in your Twitter bio before. Indoor amusement park and Hot Topic. Oh, yeah, I forgot that West Side has actually an amusement park inside. That's pretty cool. Collector's Edge, a pig collection store for cool shit. Ooh. And also Hot Topic, because we can never. A lot of people are willing to work at Hot Topic. A lot of nerdy people are willing to work at Hot Topic. I'm talking about nerdy cool people. And pops. Alright, we're going from Gdynia. I can't remember anything else right now. To Karlskrona. Also, I'm curious because I had this conversation last. Boat. But fun places. Oh, that's pretty cool. I lost my train of thought because of the fucking boat. Why does it automatically apply my parking brake? What the fuck? Holy shit. Coming boat over. Wait a minute, how in the world did you make me get out of there? When there's no port right there, Idiots. And I went straight when I should have went left, it's okay. I'll get that road eventually if I go out that port.
Apparently, most places don't hire for the summer until the end of this month. Interesting. So they consider spring till the end of May. Oh, okay. That's interesting. So they do, I guess, meant for... I'm assuming it's also meant for people who are applying from school, like high school or like that. And once they get out, it's like, all right, here you go. If you want to have a job, you can work in the summer. Da-da-da-da. It's stupid. Aww. That is a bit weird, though.
I don't know what's an EB Games. I don't know what's an EB Games. All I heard was a GameStop.
I know, they're the same company, technically. Ooh, God. You know what? I think I still got time to repair my truck. I'm gonna repair my truck. Since I'm here, actually. There it is. That's how we tell.
Where's the repair shop? I wanna go to the repair shop. Fuck, fuck, fuck.
Ouch. Sorry. I broke some tomatoes doing that. Whoopsie. Sorry, tomatoes. I didn't mean to do that. Finally, a repair shop. I haven't been in a repair shop since forever. Repair. It's actually one of the three in my city still called EB Games. Other are called GameStops. Interesting. They never bothered to change the name? Or they said, fuck it. You just keep the name, but you're operated as a GameStop. Because that's interesting. And I guess next question. I'm curious about this because I know it's happening here in the United States for GameStop. And EB Games, I think it's EB Games East Coast, I think. Nope. Interesting. Probably. Something. Is that a car? My question is have they start in the EB Games / GameStops, wherever in the city, have they started doing, the video games and the other half ThinkGeek store? Because I know that's becoming a transition here in most of the American GameStop EB Games, I think. They have a half GameStop and then a small section for ThinkGeek items. And basically like gaming, not game for peripherals, ThinkGeek. Like ThinkGeek within, a GameStop, because I know they're all ThinkGeek now owns GameStop. Also, take your time, Izzy. I might be ending here soon. So, if you end up coming back here as I'm still streaming, cool. Ooh, shit. But yeah, like a ThinkGeek, like it's like a geeky store. I think, I don't know if you've heard of that before. I can't remember. I think you did. I can't remember it right now. Not sure. I know it's like one whole wall, all games, other wall, merchant game tech with clearance bins. Alright, so it's basically like any other GameStop, EB Games, like in the Americas. Alright, that's cool. Yeah, that's roughly the same. Ooh, that car was running pretty close to that one. I think I can make it. God damn it! I didn't see you there. Also, ThinkGeek I've heard and ordered from. Yeah, there used to be a website thing, but they're starting to integrate with GameStop and EB Games, I'm assuming, because GameStop owns ThinkGeek, and they're planning to implement mini stores over in most GameStops, if not all. I didn't even see that car coming there. It's like, where did you come from? I thought it was clear. I think this is the police. I shouldn't really anger the police. I want to pass this. I'm going to pass it. I'm gonna pass it with legal. Passed it in legal speed. I did it. Now, time to keep it at 73. Because I know the police is still in front of me. I can't really speed away from that. So I'll keep it at a decent speed. Watching you try makes me nervous. It's okay, I don't do this in real life, I promise. I really don't. This is something I never do in real life. But I'm willing to do some batshit crazy shit on in-game. I think I can speed up now. Because I'm going to need that momentum going uphill. There we go, much better. Well, how is driving going? It's still going good. I've been planning to drive a little bit more tomorrow and hopefully practice on parallel parking, just in case if they do test on parallel parking. I've heard they don't do that in California anymore, but I'm going to learn it anyways because it's a good thing to learn whenever you need to actually parallel park. So that's where I'm that's what me and my dad are planning to do tomorrow. Otherwise, it's going pretty good. I need to eventually schedule the driving exam over at the DMV soon. Oh shit, that's not passing me. That's not passing me. Come on. Okay. But yeah, I've been doing some driving sessions with my dad, just driving around, trying to get used to turning again, just getting used to turning and all that stuff, whatnot. But I'm planning to do that hopefully. I have to look online and see when I could do the appointment. I want to go around you, but I can't. Come on! How is parking? Still trashy? Like I'm still rough when doing the parking. I still tend to oversteer a little bit and hit the curb, which is an instant fail, so I gotta still keep practicing that anyways. So like overall, aside from parking really, I'm good in the driving. I just need to get used to the parking part and reversing and all that stuff. And hopefully when I'm all ready and I don't hit the curb anymore. Exactly, yeah, no, I'm planning to do that. I'm not planning to schedule it till maybe after graduation. Hopefully by after graduation, I probably have done better at the parking and the reversing. And then from there, if I'm ready, I will then schedule it. Hopefully I'll schedule it by the end of May. That's what I'm planning to do, so I can have the appointment in June, and then hopefully have the license ready by then. That's like my prospective plans. Assuming that I could at least get used to reversing and not hitting the curb when parking. Because once I do that, I'm golden. Good. Oh, thank you. So I can't wait. Hopefully by then. Yeah, hopefully by next month I'll have my license. We'll see how. Also, so weird. I'm not usually drained by being social, but God, just being social is hard today. Aw. I mean, you interacted with people-ish, I think. Did you interact with people aside from me on stream? Aw. But you're always like a social person. No. So. Maybe it's taking a toll on you coming back to it, I guess. Ooh, that sharp turn. Well, I'm pretty sure you're gonna get back into it, though. Because you're always a social person, no matter what. Daryl, I had to ask him. Oh! Okay, yeah, I could see why that's tiring. No, yeah. Yeah, you talk to quite a bit of people. Dang. Okay, yeah, I could see it now. Never mind. Right, I figured you talk to a lot of people doing that. man, damn, I wish I could do such a thing like that. Just talk directly to people like that and say, are you hiring? Sometimes I could. Most of the times I can't. But yeah. Oof. I did a face-to-face thing more than the online thing. Ah, I see. Yeah, no, I'm still kind of terrible at that. Like, when it comes to talking like that, I can't do it first time around. But yeah, I definitely should do that more. It's like when it's like a professional, like when it's like a topic like that, when I try to like see if I can get applied there, I always kind of hate rejection, even though I should take rejection at all times, because you might not know. Because usually they don't know, usually you don't know, and hearing a no is not technically the end of the world. But that's just my mentality. But yeah, I definitely need to do that more. I need to get to places, send out resumes. I need to go to actually a few places and see if they got my resume or not. Maybe tomorrow? No, I can't do it tomorrow. Maybe Saturday. I'll probably hang out with friends Saturday and do that. Most places say no, but we're still taking resumes, so give it to them and say thank you. Oh, okay. I did not think they would actually do such a thing. Huh. Usually I think they would just say no, please try again later, or go online. That's just my thought. Boop. Alright, let me drive to that dealership that I saw over there. I'm going to park it over there and rest, I think. So I'm getting close to the end of the stream here. Actually, this is going to be... I'm going to start winding down now. So, yeah, this is the second load. I've been going for actually a little over 2 hours. Apply to the dollar store. Ooh, all the dollar items. I hope you get dollar discounts. I'm pretty sure you're going to remember it later. And it's like, oh, now I remember all the places I've applied to. Oh, I don't think about actually applying to Dollar Tree. But yeah, I hope you guys had a fun time watching tonight over on Truck and Talk Thursdays. I know there's quite a bit of people actually showed up tonight. Thank you for everyone that showed up for this. Hopefully I meet the over average for that for affiliate status. If you guys like what you watch, I want to see more of this, like past Truck and Talk Thursdays and whatnot. See if you like it. Head over to... I jumped the gun on this. It's alright, I was planning to get to it before I got sidetracked with when you said you went to the dollar store. that was my fault actually getting sidetracked. I think I took the wrong turn. Fuck me. But yeah. Where was I? Yeah, if you guys like what you see right now, go subscribe over at YouTube. I upload the VODs for Chicken Talk Thursdays over there. I started ever since February, so I have like quite a bit in there. I also have other videos that I record. There's a vlog coming out this Friday, aka tomorrow, where I went to San Francisco on Monday, earlier this Monday. Oop, that's not the dealership. That is the dealership. It is the refresh shop. Okay. So go over there, go watch that if you want to see more of what I did on that Monday. If you like to see my derpiness daily, go follow me on Twitter. That's where sometimes I tweet shit and all that shit, because it's shit. That's terrible. Sometimes I do take some really good photos whenever I go out places. That's where I post it over on Instagram. Go also follow me on Instagram there for to look at some nice pretty photos. It's all good stuff, so I talk a lot more spam. But yeah, I'm gonna park this. Let's see if it actually stops raining once I'm here. Oh shit, I'm gonna hit that truck. Come on, I can park this. I can at least do backwards parking. Okay, there we go. I'm hitting the line anyways, fuck me. Oh, I feel sad for anyone who wants to park there. Okay. There you go. Okay, let's see if it still rains. Ew, it's still... Oh, no, it's raining. It's raining, folks. Well, I guess this is where I'm going to end the stream. So I hope you guys have a great night, assuming it's night for a good majority that is watching. Hope you guys had a great time watching Truck and Talk Thursdays. And I think next week, since we just got the major update, 1.3.1,
we are going back to American Truck Simulator briefly to explore some new places. I think the update for ATS has come. So we're gonna jump into that briefly, starting 2 weeks from now, right? Starting 2 weeks from now, I'll jump over to American Truck Simulator, see if we explore some new things, and then we'll flip-flop back between ATS and ATS2. Planning to get the France expansion hopefully soon for this game. I hope you guys had a great time. I'll see you... If I'm planning to stream sometime next week, maybe. Otherwise, I'll see you 2 weeks from now from the next Truck and Talk Thursdays. So hope you guys have a great night. This is Spam Waits. Wrong key. See ya. There we go. I'm like at the wrong spot. Bloop. Yes, I want to stop.